Hello, Stampers! Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. Today we're going to make a Christmas card. I'm going to make one and show you three more. So all four cards will be using the exact same products, and it's really not that many products. So the cards are pretty easy. They're just a little putsy. Not hard at all, but there's quite a few layers that are on these cards, more than I normally use, but they're beautiful. It's a very elegant card using the poinsettias. So as we go through this, remember, I will have all the measurements for you over on my website. Right down there in the description of this video will be a link that will take you to the exact blog post that will give you all the measurements for the card I'm making, as well as for the other three that I'm going to share with you today. Honestly, I don't have the measurements written down here. I pre-cut everything and I don't know what they are offhand. So just hop over to my website and you'll get all of these measurements if you'd like to make these cards. And then while you're over there, if you'd like to order any of the products I feature today, I just want to say thank you in advance for selecting me to be your Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. And if you have questions or I can help you in any way, or if you'd like a catalog, go over to the website. I'd be happy to help you in any way I can. Now, that was a lot of chit-chatting. I don't like to do that. I like to get right to stamping. So let's go ahead, flip this camera down, and let's get stamping. Just a quick peek at the products I'm using today. They're from the Poinsettia Place Suite. Now, I'm not using everything. For my stamp set, I'm only using greetings that are in the stamp set. So realistically, if you like the card I have and you have other Christmas greetings, you could get just the dies. These dies are gorgeous, which you're going to see here in just a second. And then we're going to go ahead and add these beautiful beaded pearls. Otherwise, that's all we're really using from the suite. So let's set this aside and let's get to our project. Now, like I mentioned in the beginning, we're just going to use primarily the dies. So we've got lots of die cutting to do. So with my Stampin' Cut machine, because these are thin dies, we're going to use the number one. We're going to add the number two for these thin dies. We're going to do a cutting plate, number three, and then here's our cardstock. Now, these dies are unique. We've had a few like this in the past, but they're actually two dies that sandwich together. So the outside one is going to cut our image. The inside one is just going to emboss it. Now, I will tell you, I cheated. I matched these up before I came to the video here. These do go a specific way. They're not symmetrical. So when you first start playing with these, you have to kind of twist them around to figure out how they fit, because they only do fit one way. So you could even put little marks on them. If you're going to cut out a whole bunch of these, maybe mark this piece and that piece so that you know those are the petals that go together. It would probably just make it a little bit easier for you. So we're going to take this over to the Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine and cut those out. And then while I'm there, I'm also going to cut out my two leaves. I'll just show you these here. These are the same way. The outside piece will cut. The inside piece, let's see, and again, these, they only go one way, and I set it on there the wrong way. They only go one way, and this inside piece is what is going to do the embossing, which you're going to see in a second. Oops, stuck to my finger, because they do just make beautiful things. And then we've got this little twig, I guess we'll call it, and we're going to cut this out of our gold paper. I'm going to cut two of these. So while I'm gone, I'm going to do all the cutting, and then we'll come back and put this card together. So while we're doing our die cut, I'm going to go ahead and emboss this layer that I have for you, but I want to show you the embossing folder I'm using. It's the Wrapped in Texture embossing folders. I'm going to use a little dotted one. This has caused kind of some confusion. This is in the holiday catalog, but these are actually two smaller size embossing folders. It does have the mini symbol there. Now, the mini Stampin' Cut and Emboss machine is not available yet, but anything that's marked mini will fit in a regular machine. They just indicate mini so that you know it also fits in the mini one. So I just wanted to kind of explain that. And this is a standard embossing folder. We don't have a lot of the standard ones anymore. This is the thinner style. So again, when you look on here, you can find your card, your sandwich recipe. So standard is our number one, a number three, our embossing folder with cardstock, and another number three. So let me go emboss this and then we're ready for our card. So let's put some more of our card. Well, actually, we're going to stamp first. So I have a piece of Whisper White here, which is going to be the inside of our card. like I said, we've got lots of layers going here. So we're going to have May the Magic and Wonder. Boy, my table's a little shaky there. And then we're going to stamp real low here, the Merry Christmas. Now, again, if you don't think you're going to use all the different stamps in the stamp set and you have other Christmas greetings, you certainly could make this card by just getting the dies, because the focus really is going to be those beautiful poinsettia dies, which you'll see here in a second. So we're going to layer that. Oops, and I smeared it just a little bit. See, I smear too, but that's okay. If there weren't smears and smudges on it, it wouldn't be homemade, right? So we're going to go ahead and adhere this to the inside of our card. You can see how elegant that gold makes it look. Again, nothing hard, just lots of parts and pieces, we're going to call it, to our card. So let's set that aside and let's build our focal layer here. We've got our poinsettia pieces and we need to grab our dimensionals. So you can see here, we'll see if the camera picks it up. Can you see the embossing on there? It's got like all the little veins. It really just adds so much to it. Now to add just a little bit more texture, I'm going to take my bone folder and kind of distress these a little bit. Hold in the middle. You want to be careful that you don't pull off any of the leaves, but I like to kind of go both ways with them, and then you can even come back up if you want. We want them going a little bit in, you know, different directions, and that just makes them a little bit more bendable, we'll call it. So let's go around on all three of these. Now you certainly don't have to do this, but I think it just adds a little more texture to these pretty flowers. So there's that one. And then let's just do our last little one. And then I'm gonna just use some dimensionals and stick all three of these together. So we might need to get some mini ones. I think that barely fits on the medium size. Actually, it sticks out a little bit there, you can see, but we're gonna cover that up. So let's stick that down, then let's grab the mini dimensionals. Here we go. So let's put one of these underneath. You gotta make sure you put these the right way so that you see that embossing on them. And then each one, as we put it on there, we just kind of turn it a little bit. So you can see how we've built our flower, which we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna put it right in the center here of our embossed piece. So let's just go ahead and stick that right there. Use that liquid adhesive, especially on this embossing, because we wanna make sure it's gonna stick on there. And then we can go ahead with our two leaves. Now with these, I'm putting my dimensionals up towards the top so that there's room to kind of push it underneath our flower a little bit. So we'll stick one there. It's okay if it comes off a little bit off this layer, because remember, this is just a layer that's going to go on our card. So let's go ahead and kind of offset it. Let's go about right there on that one. Then I cut out these pretty gold branches. I think these are just stunning. And to adhere these, we're going to go ahead and put some of this liquid adhesive down towards the bottom. And again, we're going to just kind of stick it underneath that flower there. I hope that's not too high up. Let's see. Sometimes we got to double check. Nope, we're good there. And then we'll go ahead and come down. You know what? Actually, we're going to stick this one in just a little bit further here. So we'll break off a little piece, put some adhesive on there, and we'll stick that one right in there like so. And it'll stick down great. So this is how this card is going to go together. Now we want to use one of these beaded pearls. Now I will tell you, these are fairly heavy. And with all this layer and that gold paper and stuff, the whole card is a little bit heavy. I'm not so sure I would recommend mailing this one. Or if you do, you're going to want to put it in a padded envelope. But this would be a gorgeous card that you could give to someone that you're going to hand deliver, is kind of what I would recommend. Now, when we put this layer on, we want to make sure we just put adhesive up towards the top there. And we're going to go ahead and layer that. We want to make sure we're up high enough so that we see our Merry Christmas, but not too high, so those pieces stay within our card. And there you go. So you can see lots of layers here. It was an easy card, just a lot of cutting and a lot of layers. Now, would you like to see the other three I have for you? Now, these three cards I did not design. I was actually a presenter at another demonstrator's event not too long ago. Tina and her sister did a great, it was a retreat for demonstrators, and they asked me to speak, and in return, I got all of their make and takes. So these were actually three projects that were part of the event's make and take packet. So it was kind of fun because they sent me the packet, and all I had to do was stamp and cut and put together. But this card, and I kind of designed mine off of their basic ideas. Lots of embossing. The only stamping is that stamp set are the greetings in it. But the focus point really is that poinsettia. And these are all cut a little bit differently. You can see here, just the bottom section is there. We've cut off the top of it. But look at how pretty that is. And then this one opens up like so. But again, there you go, my friends. Four different cards that all really focus on using those poinsettia dies, and then just lots of cutting. So as a reminder, down in the description of this video, you will find the link to the blog post where I'll have pictures of all four of these cards along with the cutting measurements for you. I'll also have a list of all the supplies I use, and if you'd like to place an order to get them so that you can make these gorgeous cards yourself, you can do that right over there as well. So I hope you enjoyed the projects today. A little bit over the top for the normal types of projects I share with you, but I thought you'd enjoy just the elegance of these cards. So until I stamp with you again, have a stamp happy day.